Vedas has no beginning. Like the Supreme God, it exists forever. God is in the form of Vedas. Earlier, Vedas was taught orally from a guru to his disciple. So it existed only in the oral form. It was Vedavyasa who organized and segregated it to four parts and brought it to written form. Just as how Chief Minister, Prime Minister are the titles given to the persons who occupy that position. Vedavyasa is the title given to the person who organizes and segregates Veda. In every Dwapara Yuga, this Veda compilation work is done for the well-being of all in this world. Krishna Dvaipayana is the Vedavyasa now whom we celebrate as Lord Vishnu's avatar. He is the son of sage Parasara, author of Vishnu Purana. His mother is the fisherwoman Satyavati. He is the 28th Vedavyasa of this Manvantara. As how we say a month, a year, a decade, a century, our Puranas very commonly use the terms Yuga, Kalpa, Manvantara to denote time period. The Vedas' philosophies are not very simple to understand. So, for us to understand it easily, Vedavyasa also wrote 18 Puranas along with it. 18 Puranas are Agni Purana, Bhagavata Purana, Bhavishya Purana, Brahma Purana, Brahmanda Purana, Brahma Vaivarta Purana, Garuda Purana, Kurma Purana, Linga Purana, Markandeya Purana, Matsya Purana, Padma Purana, Shiva Purana, Skanda Purana, Vamana Purana, Varaha Purana, Vayu Purana and Vishnu Purana. A text should have five characteristics or Pancha Lakshana to be classified as a Purana. They are, number one, they should speak about the creation of the universe. Number two, about secondary creations, mostly recreations after dissolution. Number three, it should speak about the great Vamshas or the genealogy of the great Rishis and Devatas. Number four, it should speak about Manvantras or rule of Manus. Number five, it should give a detailed description of the dynasties of kings who lived and ruled this world. Mostly the great Surya Vamsh or the Chandra Vamsh or the Solar and Lunar dynasties. Puranas were said either by God or Devas or Rishis for the first time to others. Only at last it reached Vedavyasa and took the written form. For example, Shiva Purana was said by Brahmadeva to Narada, Kurma Purana was said by Pulastya to Narada, Garuda Purana was said by Garuda to Rishi Kashyapa, Markandeya Purana was said by Markandeya Maharishi to Vedavyasa's disciple Jaimini, Agni Purana was said by Agnideva himself to Vasishtha Maharishi, Vishnu Purana was said by Matsyavatar Vishnu to Manu, Varaha Purana was said by Varaha himself and Kanda Purana by God Kanda himself. In each Purana, it will be said very clearly in the beginning itself by whom it is said again and to whom it is said. Vishnu Purana was said by Parasara Maharshi to Rishi Maitreya, Shiva Purana, Linga Purana and Brahma Purana was said by Suta Mahamuni to the Rishis who were along with Saunaka Maharishi at Naimisaranya forest. Vaisambayana learnt the Puranas and epics from Vedavyasa's son Sukha Brahmarshi. He then said that to Parikshit, the king of Hastinapur. At that time, Suta Mahamuni, who was present there, heard that attentively. Later, he said that at Naimisharanya forest to Rishi Saunakara and other Rishis with him. As how on a birthday function or on an award function, we praise and talk about the achievements of that particular person. In a Purana also, we give prime importance to the respective god about which it speaks. We shouldn't take it as a discrimination towards other gods. We should not see Puranas with our current lifestyle. Things that we were thinking are real facts till yesterday has turned out to be false today.
Lots of practices which our previous generation dropped, we have taken it and adapted it, understanding the facts behind it to be true. So, it is good that we say the Puranas as such to the next generation and leave it to their research. We either can't accept or can't understand the meaning behind few things said in Puranas, but it is our duty to say them as such. The narration of this Purana begins with the prayers to Lord Shiva, Goddess Parvati, and Lord Ganesha.